Chad, I'm coming in. I wanted to apologize for my father. Tends to just say whatever is on his mind, but he only means well. He really cares about you, you know? I'm sure that's why he asked as soon as we arrived.
It's fine. There's no need to apologize. He couldn't have known it's me. It just caught me off guard. With all that's been going on, I forgot why you came to me in the first place.
Yeah, about that, I can explain.
I think I am starting to understand. I thought we were happy together, but I'm sure I messed it all up. I can't blame you for not loving me anymore. Especially now. I lied to you. I should have told you that I knew about you. That was stupid of me.
I lied too. I lied when I said I didn't love you anymore. And when I said we weren't right for each other. I didn't mean any of those words, I swear. How could I ever stop loving you, Adrian? You're so kind and funny and smart and caring. I don't mind the whole identity thing. I'm happy.
Wait, what? So you're not breaking up with me? But I don't understand. What was all this about then?
The reason I came to your house today was your father. I didn't want to tell you about this. I wanted to just quickly do as I've been told. I thought this was the right thing to do, but I guess I didn't think things through. I ended up putting us in a great danger and...
My father?
Yeah. It all happened so fast. He came to the bakery. Well, Natalie did. They said something about a relationship having a negative impact on the brand. All of a sudden, they demanded I break up with you immediately. Your father said he wouldn't let you go to school otherwise. It's cruel. You fought so hard to be here. I didn't want to take any risk, you know? So I just went ahead and did it.
He blackmailed you? My father blackmailed you! He made you blame yourself for what he put you through. Why? How could he do something like that to you? It's not unlike him to interfere with my personal choices, but this? Dragging you into all of this? It's messed up. You weren't harming anyone. Why didn't he talk to me first? I'm his son. It's ridiculous. We could have figured it all out.
I'm so sorry, Kitty.
How could he do that to you? How dare he?
It's okay. I'm Adrian. Fine.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean to get all riled up.
Please, don't apologize. And don't worry about me. I'm okay. I'm sure we can both figure something out about your dad and the brand. There's gotta be a way to fix everything. I mean, I would know, right? I'm basically Fix-It Felix, except I'm Ladybug. That is basically the same thing. Also, I'm a tough opponent for anyone, even for your father. Wait. No. That just sounds like I want to fight your father. I won't do that. That would be ridiculous. I want him to like me. Unless you want me to fight him. I'll take on the world for you. What I mean is that I'm...
Marinette, thank you.
Huh?
And you too, Tiki.
Hi, Adrian. Wait, why are you thanking Sugar Cube? She didn't even say anything.
Don't be rude, Plague. This is her home too. Least we can do is thank her for having us.
Doubt she would ever mind having me around.
Yeah, you're charming, eh?
I know. Besides, if you want to thank anyone, thank me. By treating my empty stomach. I did all the work. P.
I was about to. You didn't even give me a chance.
Plague, now's really not the time for your whining.
Ooh, don't be mad, Sugar Cube. I'm lightening the mood.
Eh?
I'm so happy it's you.
I'm glad you're not breaking up with me.
Aw, maybe we should leave.
Gross.
I would never, Kitty.
Black.
I'm kidding. They are pretty cute, I guess. I'm still waiting to be fed.